Guys, welcome back to another video. This is from May 19th, 2022. This is my first time at York. So, of course, this is going to be one of those stadium tour videos. So, it's going to be a longer video. They're playing the Lancaster Barnstormers. Basically, they're next door neighbors. The two cities are not that far apart. And if you didn't know, you might be able to tell, and I might even like mention it. During the video, you might hear me talk about this, that the stadiums are not completely identical, but very, very similar. They were built by the same company, and, you know, from the entranceway is the same, to the basic layout of the concourse is all the same. So the only difference is there's a gigantic, green monster in left field at York, which, by the way, is taller than Boston. It is the tallest wall in professional baseball, if you didn't know that. And there's really not that much left to say about this. I did get some stuff, you know, being my first time there. You can see that at the end of the video. And other than that, thanks for watching and enjoy the video.
Backwards for the drivers to see it.
Yeah, actually.
I never really been there.
Was this designed?
Walk.
So it is right here.
I think they're designed by the same company.
You can walk around this stadium, right?
Yeah.
Actually, it is very similar to Lancaster, where you go behind something to get around.
This has a picnic area too.
This is designed exactly like Lancaster is, it seems like. Kind of worries. Flag up there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I couldn't see it. I see that. Right here in this corner.
That's what it looks like.
They have a sign, cannon firing zone. Yeah, I know I keep saying it, but like this out here is even exactly like Lancaster.
Yep.
The only difference is they have a giant wall here in left field. Bye. Manual scoreboard stuff right there.
Oh yeah.
Southern Maryland is still on there.
What's the plate number is playing, huh?
I guess so. I see zeros on the back of those. I guess they have signs on the back of them so they know what they are from back here. Yeah. It's cool. I've never seen that.
Well, yeah, they have all the numbers, I guess, in there somewhere.
Yeah. Obviously, the only other place that has it now, I guess, besides here is Boston, I guess. I don't know how many other teams have manual scoreboards.
Eh, it might be a few minor league parks that install them just for fun.
Yeah, well, yeah, much like here.
Yeah.
And we found the crowds again.
This happening presented by Splash Wire. Third baseman number 33. Thank you.
Airports keeps changing jackets.
Yeah, he's in a different jacket now.
First baseman, number 12, and ready for zero.
Get down! No! That's...
Hey all Reds fans and Lexington Legends will visit PeoplesBank Park for a three-game weekend series with the first game tomorrow at 6:30. We appreciate your support of your Revolution Baseball here at PeoplesBank Park. Have a great rest of your day.
Okay, so this is everything gotten from the York Revolution on May 19th, 2022. Let's start with the souvenir cup here. At first, I thought that the dishwasher kind of messed us up, because it's done that before, where it kind of adds like white marks, and you know, it's basically like the paint or whatever is on the cup peeling, and that's what I thought this was at first, but it's just part of the logo, because part of this is the home run cannon. If you didn't know, they have the home run cannon, and yeah, and basically I assume that's supposed to be part of this logo, because you see kind of like steam and then some sparks at the bottom of the York Revolution logo. But basically I really like this cup because it's just simple. It's a panorama from the outfield of the stadium during sunset. It's really cool, and there's not, you know, too much to say about it, but it's a really cool cup. Can I see what team they're playing? They're playing Lancaster at the time, the same team I saw. Anyway, here is the printed ticket as well. It's Revs time, Lancaster, May 19th, 11 a.m. Some ads. So you got a program here, but before we do that, let's go over the pocket schedule. You see 15th anniversary. It actually reminds me a couple other things. Be right back. Okay, so before we do the pocket schedule, let's do shirt and hat. I'm so out of the loop from doing new stadiums that I completely forgot I have a shirt and hat, which I normally do at new stadiums and arenas, but it's been so long since I've been to one I've never been to before. So this is very simple. 15 seasons, York Revolution. You see you have, I want to say the mascot, but that's not really their mascot. The eagle claw grabbing the 15 on a gray shirt here, and that's, you know, pretty much it. Then we have the hat, which, you know, I like the hats that are closest to what they use on the field. So this is the Y, the lowercase y, with the eagle with the baseball in its mouth. Atlantic League Professional Baseball on the side. Revolution on the back, and then the company on the side. So now let's look at the pocket schedule. Have, you know, just the stadium. You have your ticket prices. You have the actual schedule, which is all pretty straightforward except for you know, the marked ones. This is very interesting. I've never mentioned this on the channel before, I don't think. 10 p.m., they have an 11 a.m. game, followed by the Friday, 10 p.m. That's not a typo. That is 10 p.m. They are starting a game at 10 p.m. I'm not going to go, but I'm very interested to watch that online and see how many people are actually there, especially at the end when it's going to be like 1 in the morning. And here's your promotions. There's Midnight Madness, and then some ads here. And now let's move on to the program, which I have to remember, was it free? I think, yeah, it was free, because they just had like little girls like handing it out as soon as you walked in the gate. So yeah, this is a free free program. Just gonna quickly roll through it. For a free program, it does have a decent amount of content, by the way. It's not just, you know, one of those free programs where it's just loaded with ads and the only real content you get is maybe like a roster or something. It is a real program that has some good content in it, like park policies. You have your map of all the concessions and stuff. You have an ad for the app, which if you have the Somerset Patriots app, which I do, it's the same exact app, same company. And you have sponsors. You have the whole staff, including the dog, which I don't remember, but you might see in the video, in the highlight video. And this is a specific program for the month of May, so this is all of the teams that they play in May. Coupon for free pretzel, by the way. And here's one of the articles. This looks like an article, but it's just a giant ad. Coaching staff. The scorecard that I never used because I had my own. Some more ads. Did you know, even though they are advertising, you know, Phillies equals 76ers, I was interested to hear that I was so far south in Pennsylvania that I was technically in the Baltimore market. It was very interesting. I was listening to a Yankee game on the radio driving back to New Jersey, and it was actually the Baltimore broadcast, not the Yankee broadcast. So it was very interesting. But anyway, another quick article. I actually found this article very interesting. It's about when they opened and all that. And it apparently was not finished when they opened. There was a lot of stuff that wasn't finished, including clubhouses and stuff. They basically had them in trailers in the parking lot. Whole bunch of other stuff. Penn State York. Penn State has a campus in like every city, I've noticed. Every stadium I go to in Pennsylvania, there seems to be a Penn State somewhere. Penn State York, Penn State Harrisburg, Penn State, I don't really stop here, but Penn State Hazleton, I think, is one of them. Only city that I really don't see them at is like Allentown. there you go. Little spot for autographs, and then here's kind of, you know, same schedule we already went over, a little bit different format being on a full page, and yeah, there you go. So that is pretty much it for me. I thank you for watching, and I will see you all later.